I had a rescue dog, wonderful dog named Roosevelt. We now have a new dog, Bear. And Ramon, before I introduce you, Bear's driving us crazy. He's a puppy, but he's great. But we have today Ramon. Ramon, how about introduce yourself to everybody else? Then we'll talk baseball and wrestling and all that good stuff.
Well, thanks for having me.
Thanks for being here.
So my name is Ramon Villatoro. I'm the chief of animal services, and I've been in animal welfare for the past 11 years.
Okay.
And it's funny, I initially had aspirations to be in the culinary field.
Really, a cook?
But my older sister, Teresa, was a behaviorist at the Animal Welfare League at Alexandria in Virginia.
Where you grew up.
Where I grew up. And she convinced me to give animal welfare, animal sheltering a shot.
And now you're running a whole county agency.
11 years later.
Congratulations. And also, thank you, sister.
Yeah.
What's your sister's name?
Yeah, Teresa.
Teresa, thank you very much.
And and Teresa, to me, is someone who I always aspire to be, you know, and emulate everything. So the standards she
now, she's a cook now, right?
No. She's still continued her behavior work.
Good for her.
And she's still in animal sheltering. So
good for her.
Owe everything to her.
Older sister?
Older sister.
Okay, and where's she? And she's stayed in Virginia with the animal stuff?
She stayed in Arlington, Virginia. She's currently working at the Animal Welfare League of Arlington.
Okay. Now, let me ask this because I'm a dummy. Animal behavior, what does that mean? Actually training the animals?
Yes. So she is very into, she actually specializes in cat behavior.
Yeah, it's okay.
And a lot of folks, when they think of behavior, they think of dog training. You know, dogs is always put in the front runner. So Teresa's always veered towards cat behavior.
Okay.
Understanding their behavior. And
she specializes just in cats.
Right.
Very good. The silent cats who sleep 70% of their lives.
Right.
That's good behavior. Ramon, and I'm an old man, that sounds good to me.
Right.
Now, look at it. Just a couple more minutes. You were really enjoyed, you said, high school wrestling. Tell everyone a little bit about that.
I did. I was really into wrestling during my high school years, which kind of laid the foundation of discipline and my work ethic.
Okay.
That's helped me get to where I am today. But I've been in this field 11 years. I spent 6 years in animal sheltering in Northern Virginia.
Okay.
And in very well-funded organizations, very pretty much leaders in the industry. And during my year six, I wanted to really challenge myself and see if I could bring my skill set to a rural shelter.
You've been 11 years here in the Queen Anne's County, or did you actually start across the bridge?
I started in Northern Virginia.
Okay.
So
okay.
I've been about 4 years on the shore.
On the shore, you know. Okay.
But yeah,
Ramon, I've been here 45 and they still call me a chicken nugger. So it's I'm gonna warn you, it's not gonna change, okay?
No. Luckily I haven't been called a chicken nugger yet.
You won't be.
But so that's what's brought me to Queen Anne's County. I joined Queen Anne's County when it was the Animal Welfare League in 2018.
Okay, before we get, and just a couple more minutes, as all fathers, you were an avid wrestler and your son is a avid
baseball player.
Of course, that's the way it works.
Yeah.
My son, I liked all sports, but he was a great football player and he got into lacrosse. I didn't even know how many people were on a lacrosse team.
Right.
And I got to enjoy just watching, as you tell me you're doing with baseball.
Right.
The kids bring us, they educate us rather than the other way around,
right?
Which is good, okay.
Yeah.
And but don't give up. There's a wonderful Little League wrestling program around. You can get them, right?
Right.
Okay.
Right.
Now tell me, I don't know anything about, your animal service. Probably, unfortunately, most of the people out there don't. Give us the ABCs.
Yeah, so Queen Anne's County Animal Services, we are the open admissions animal shelter for the county. And what open admissions means is we accept all stray animals found in Queen Anne's County.
Okay.
And also we accept all owner surrendered pets for Queen Anne's County residents.
Now, please.
And regardless of age, temperament, and health, we accept them.
Okay, so if someone can't handle a pet, they can just drive up or do they call up? Or how does that
work? They can call up, they can schedule a time, and we really try to develop an environment at the shelter where it's a non-judgmental zone.
Okay.
We're here to be
help the animals
of service to the residents. And in some cases, whether it's medical or behavioral, that's where we're here to help in those cases.
Well, you guys were terrific. Years ago, our rescue, we had a Yorkie. And tragically, the woman who owned it died of cancer. And the husband just couldn't. The dog reminded, just memories of a family with a pet. And you guys not only help the dog, obviously, but you help the husband get through this whole thing. You guys did a good job, and we thank you for the dog, and I know the husband right. thanks you for right. getting him through a tough time. You know, speaking on that, toughest things I see in social media, occasionally you see a picture of a dog. This right. dog is running on a street.
Right.
Now, you all help with that. Someone can put the dog in the car. How does that work?
Right. Yeah. So if you are to find a stray animal, cat mm-hmm. or dog, and they are found in Queen Anne's County, you can drop off at our facility, and we will make attempts to reunite with the okay. owner. And fortunately for 2021, we have had great success with reuniting some
of
the lost pets.
Oh, great. Terrific.
But that's what we're here for. And we have staff at the facility pretty much every day of the week, even through holidays. So even if you find someone during Christmas Eve, Christmas Day,
you can help out. Oh, it breaks my heart when I see these beautiful animals.
Right.
And they just run, right? They're like, they just run. Now, Ramon, let's stop for a second. Help us. Where are you? A lot of people saying, where are you guys?
Right. So we are located on 201 Clay Drive in Queenstown, right by the Rural Farms.
Okay. Easy to see on the highway, right?
Easy to see. Right.
I've done some dog walking. It's terrific because you have grass going both ways.
Yeah, it's a great location.
And it's easy to pull off of 301 yes. and get a cup of coffee if you want it, or whatever. Okay. Is there a number or website they can also call? We'll do this a couple
sure.
of times. Go ahead.
Yeah, there is our telephone number is 410-827-7178.
Okay, one more time.
410-827-7178.
Great. And do you have a website?
We do. It's on the Queen Anne's County page, but okay. it's a www.qac.org.
And just go for
animal services.
All right, so you stray animals you help, and people have to surrender them tragically.
Right.
In a year or a month, how many of either do you get?
So on average, we take in about 1,200 animals per year.
1,000 animals, and these are people coming to you saying, I just can't handle it?
Yes.
It's a lot of animals.
This year, we have broken the 1,000 animal mark, so we're expecting to get to the 1,200, 300 mark this year.
And the vast majority of those are surrenders?
I would say the majority are stray animals.
Oh, stray animals.
And the majority of those are cats.
Really?
So about 65% of our intakes are cats.
Okay. And you said you do really well with the strays. I mean, are we 50% success rate in finding their owner or not?
With dogs, we are really successful. Okay. With cats, not as successful as we'd like to be. But with dogs, we are pretty fortunate
be. And if they go to your website, will there be pictures of, we found this dog? And
yes.
Okay.
So we have, actually on our website, we have a page that's stray animals at the shelter.
Okay.
So whenever an animal comes into our facility, we mark them as a stray, and they'll be posted immediately in real time on our website, and it has a brief description and a picture of the animal.
If nobody claims them, can other people, breaking my heart here, because I have a puppy that I know wants to run.
Right. So after, we like to keep them for at least 7 to 8 days as a stray hold.
So about a week.
And after that, we'll evaluate for medical, for behavioral, and we'll put them up for adoption.
Okay, over 1,000 a year.
Yes, animals coming in our building.
That's a full-time, how many people have to do that?
So we have currently around 13 paid staff.
Okay, and that's a major job.
Right.
I thought you were going to say 25 or 30, 1,000.
Right.
Great. Now, Ramon, what else do you have going on now? Okay, so we're taking care of strays, we're taking care of people who are saying, I just can't handle this. Okay, what else we got going on down there?
So we provide a lot of services for the community. Mm-hmm. We handle the county registration for the county. And part of this, so any cat, dog, and even ferret who's 4 months and older, they require a county license.
Okay.
So we handle that process.
What is that process? Someone's saying, geez, I've got a dog.
Right,
I haven't done anything. What's the process?
So you can find the form on our page.
Go to the website and find animal services.
Right.
Okay.
And it's just the one page.
Okay.
And you fill out just a description of your pet, the rabies information and the microchip information and the address of the owner. And it's a lifetime registration, so you don't have to renew it each year.
Oh, okay.
And the cost is $11 for the registration.
That's nothing for the love you get from an animal. But that is required by county law. Okay.
Yes.
So that's dogs, cats, and ferrets.
Ferrets, yeah.
The ferret community is not happy. Okay. All right. So you do that, and that's mandatory.
Yes.
As all of you folks out there like me, I'm good though, but who haven't done something, go to the website and fill out the paperwork and pay the $11. Okay, so you handled that registration process. What else you got going on, Animal
So
services?
We also provide low-cost microchipping, and I know we spoke about the registration, that that's a mandatory part of it. So we like to provide microchipping at a low cost of
$15.
And you don't need to make an appointment.
Now explain that. We need to have that done because I know my dog is going to run them, isn't it?
So microchip, so microchip is embedded
right
between
in the
shoulder blades, underneath the skin. And what the microchip does is it provides us with a unique ID number, and it's associated with the owner. And the benefit of this microchip is if this animal were to come into our facility, picked up by animal control,
we can immediately identify it.
We could scan with a universal scanner, and it gives us information that allows us to reach out to the owner.
Easy. Do you make an appointment and just, I mean, is it an hour to do that, 2 hours to do that?
You don't need an appointment. You can come whenever we're open.
Oh, really?
And we're open from Thursday to Tuesday, 11 a.m. to 5 p.m.
Okay.
And it's a very quick process.
Like a shot?
Yes.
Oh, 15 minutes.
A 15-minute process.
So if you're worried, like I am, that your pet could get away, you just drive up, and 15, 20 minutes, they put it in the body, and then you're permanently away. So if a bear did run, and someone found it up in Chestertown, or Queenstown someplace, you can immediately identify the animal.
Yes.
Why not?
And we also will register that microchip at no cost. So we'll register with the microchip company. And another benefit of having a microchip, if your animal were to get out, it's not like a collar that can come loose when they're running through the bushes.
It's part of their body.
It's on there, so it's really beneficial to have one.
Now, I know everyone's going to ask, is it painful for the dog? Does it hurt? Or do they,
If it is painful, it's only for
it's
a
like
few seconds.
It's like a shot. It's like anything, a medicine. Right. Okay. So do that. Okay.
Right. And we also try to make the animal as comfortable as they can be. So in most cases, we have the owner assist with holding them.
Oh, okay.
That way, they don't have to be stressed out by having a stranger hold them down while they're getting a microchip.
Oh, I'm going to do that. That's great. And just drive up.
Right.
Can't beat that. Okay. Yeah. So we get strays, we get returnees, we help with the, by county law, we must register our animals, we can get a shot.
Right.
What else are we doing down there?
So we also have a pet pantry program.
Okay, what's that?
And the pet pantry program, it's if we have citizens who are facing hard times, especially with the pandemic going on, and if they're in need of cat food or dog food, they can come to our facility and get that from us.
Oh, absolutely free?
Absolutely free.
Oh, wow. So someone's going through difficult times. I mean, we got to feed ourselves first, but we got to take care of the animals. Just drive up and appointments necessary or just
no
drive up?
No appointments needed. We do have them fill out a one-time document, and it's just so we can track how much we're giving out for the year.
Any economic qualifications or any?
No.
Okay.
No, we try to make it as inclusive as possible. So really anyone who needs it, all you have to do is just come in and
you trust them that they need help.
Yes.
Okay. Well, that's a terrific, I didn't know you had that.
Yeah.
Oh Lord. I'm glad you're here, Ramon. it's terrific. Okay. So if we have a family in need of food for their animals, now this is cats, dogs, limited to
cats and dogs. Sometimes
the ferrets are raising their hand out there, Ramon.
Sometimes you have some food available for those small companions, but for the most part, yes, cats.
Okay. So we take care of that. I mean, that's terrific. It's like a food bank for animals. That's great. Okay, so we got registration, we got food banks going on, we have helping strays, et cetera. Okay, keep on going.
So we also have a program, a safekeeping program. And
are there enough hours in a week for you all to do all this?
It is a lot.
It is a lot
for the staff.
Yes,
but
it is.
The safekeeping program, it's short-term housing.
Safekeeping is called.
Safekeeping. Okay. And it's short-term housing for residents who face themselves in crisis.
Okay.
For example, if they require hospitalization.
Okay. A single person has to go to the hospital.
Right.
They don't have
Right. So we can step in and provide care for a short-term basis.
Okay. Now, what's the procedure? If I know I'm by myself, I have an operation on Tuesday, should I call? What's the procedure to do that?
In this case, we do ask that you call and schedule, and it is depending on how much space we have, but for the most part, we will step in and
assist. Okay, great, okay. Yeah. And is there any cost at all? Or?
We sometimes charge a fee of just care, and that's $10 per day.
Okay.
But for the most part,
clean up of afterwards, right, and the food and et cetera. Right. That's fair. That's more
and
than
for
fair.
The most part, most of the owners will provide with the supplies.
Okay.
So
you ask people to bring some food, right, with them if they can. Oh, right, that's terrific. Right. Okay. Well, I think rather, can we double, I think we should tell the commissioners on TV, right, here, let's double this man's staff.
Right.
I'm running out of fingers to count the things you're doing. Ramon, good, you keep going. And I'm gonna,
sure.
Before we finish, I do want you to talk about volunteers.
Absolutely.
And your dog walking. But good, you keep, yeah, going.
And the last big service I want to touch on is we do, in 2021, we had, mm, a spay and neuter voucher.
Okay.
And this was funded by the Maryland Department of Agriculture, and the purpose of this grant was to provide free spay neuters to residents.
Okay.
Now, there is a criteria to qualify for this voucher. Now, it was a 12-month grant cycle. We were able to exhaust all funds within 5 months.
Oh, wow.
So it was a very successful program. Now, we did apply for this year, and we were awarded $8,500,
okay,
to
now explain
more.
To qualify.
Yes.
Again, I'm being selfish here. My 1-year-old dog in November.
Yes.
You know, we're making it's November's. The bell is beginning to ring. Is there an economic requirement?
Yes.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. So there is a household income of under $50,000 a year.
Okay.
But there can also be, if you're receiving any type of benefit, that could be WIC, food stamps, mm-hmm, unemployment benefits with everything going on now. Medicaid, Medicare, you automatically are approved for this grant.
Okay, so somebody, again, if you have a little financial problems, which we all do in our lives at some point, there you can help them out with neutering processes. There's a procedure for that and some qualifications, but I like the idea, if you're really in a hot spot, hey, I need some food, I need some help.
Right.
And that's terrific, okay. Raymond, my favorite, I've got to tell you a story. I'm going to,
sure,
brag on you a bit. My granddaughter, one of my granddaughters, as a school project, you know, had to do so many school service learning. And wonderful, we went for, I want to think it was a couple hours of training on how to walk the dog. Your staff did a great job. And we only did it a couple times. She loved the animals. It was a grandfather. She couldn't handle it. But can you tell, what a wonderful point. You actually,
yes,
walk a dog and you do it right on your or near,
yes,
your property. Could you elaborate on that a bit?
So we have the volunteer program, and we're always recruiting for the volunteer program, and we do have one of our most popular programs is the dog walking.
Yeah.
But we also have different areas that volunteers
can assist. Please, talk about them all.
We have enrichment and socialization if folks just want to come in and socialize with their cats or dogs,
okay,
spend time with them. We have volunteers who also assist with clerical duties, assisting our front,
okay,
desk staff with.
I mean, your front desk staff, I think a lot of them are volunteers. Correct me if I'm wrong, there's always, seems like there's always a volunteer, always pleasant and always helpful.
Right, we do have a paid staff member who,
yes,
works the front desk,
right,
but
right,
we like to have a rotation of volunteers.
And you can just come and talk to the dogs that we. I mean, the dogs you have in the kennels or the cats, you can actually just come there and talk to them.
You can just come
socialize
in and spend time with them, yeah, because the environment.
Don't tell my wife, she'd rather,
right,
talk to them than me, I think.
And it's a very stressful environment, so the volunteers,
oh, yeah,
are really critical for our life-saving mission,
oh, yeah,
to provide them with a higher quality of life.
And just the experience I had with you and your staff, walking a dog, we all enjoyed it. I know the dog needed to get it. The dog we had was a dog that you guys had rescued, just producing babies, was a, you know, it was a puppy mill, or baby mill, and the dog was happier. My granddaughter and I were happier. So it's a great experience, right,
right,
for both parties, and helps your staff,
right,
a bit. Okay, so you can come and kind of socialize with them, help you out at the desk.
Right.
Probably always need, you tell me, do you need help cleaning kennels
we
and
do,
that type of stuff?
We okay do, and we have we have laundry assistants, folks who just kind of keep track with our laundry machines. We have two big industrial-sized washer and dryer.
Oh, wow.
And the volunteers will keep that running and folding the linens. But we also have volunteers who assist with the cleaning process.
Okay.
So that's another big area that we're looking
now
at.
Now, what's if I, a lot of people are watching this and saying, you know what? Sounds pretty cool.
Yeah.
What's the procedure to saying you'd like to volunteer and then can they pick the area they want?
They can.
Okay.
They can. And it's a very easy process. You can either go on our website,
right,
and we have our volunteer application that they can fill out online, or they can mail us the form.
Okay.
Or if they
again,
like.
Again, go to the website. And
yes.
Queen Anne's County. Help me again. Website again.
The Queen Anne's County page, and the animal
and
services.
And find the animal services, right. And there will be a volunteer request form. I'd like to volunteer.
Yes.
Okay. How many volunteers do you have?
Right now we have about 100 or so volunteers.
100 volunteers. And how many full-time staff?
Around 13.
The way this works, let's reverse that.
Right.
I think you need 100 full-time.
Right.
I always like when I go down there, when we got Roosevelt to rescue and the dog walking, it seems like you always have a lot of high school or college kids, and they're all friendly, full of enthusiasm, and that's a plus for you and
right.
the department, and obviously for the dogs, right?
Right.
Which is really good. Now, can you volunteer in any other way?
You can volunteer for folks who can't come to our facility.
Right,
you
right.
can volunteer by, you know, a lot of the younger folks will host pet drives, donation drives.
Okay.
And they'll bring in what they've gotten through the drives. And you can also build enrichment toys using common household items. And you
can actually
bring
build toys for the animals.
Yes,
oh,
and
wow.
you can bring them in. And if you ever have any ideas or suggestions, they can always call us and speak with our volunteer coordinator and our staff. And we can always help out, kind of find new
okay.
creative ways.
So if the people would like, and you don't care whether they can be 18-year-olds or 108-year-olds,
right.
it seems like you have a little bit of everybody
right.
there. And everybody, the older folks maybe can't do the lifting and the shoving,
right.
but they can certainly answer a phone
right.
and that type of stuff. And you mentioned donations.
Yes.
Are you looking for those? Is there a constant fundraising?
Yes.
How does that work?
So the biggest need is towels. We're always looking for towels.
Regular towels, like a towel I use? Or
yes.
Special? Okay.
And we'll use these towels for cleaning, but
okay.
also we'll line the cat cages with towels, blankets, toys, dog toys.
New or old or both?
Can be both.
Oh, wow. Now, that's easy. Everyone has
right.
five extra towels. How would they donate? Can they just drive up and say, here's five towels?
They can drive up and they can either come inside and leave it with their front desk staff, but we also have a huge yellow bin
okay.
out in the front door.
Oh, right in front.
Right in the front, and
okay.
they can place their donated items in there and we'll bring them in.
Now, folks watching, now, come on, we all go to our linen closets, and let's think about it for a second. I know I have more towels than the United States Army can use in a year, and regular full-size towels, and they can either put it in the yellow bin
yes.
or perhaps call or somehow, or just
yes.
show up with them.
Yes.
Oh, come on, we can, this county can get 50,000 people, we'll give you 50,000 towels, come on. Jim Moran has 100 he's not using. Come on, Jim, help us out. Okay, how about other financial gifts?
We do sometimes accept financial gifts
okay.
through, since we are a municipal agency.
You gotta be careful.
Right, so, but we do accept them through our component fund, Chesapeake Charities.
Okay.
We have a Friends of.
Okay, now talk Queen about Queen. how would they, someone's saying, you know what, I don't want to give time, I don't want to give towels, but by golly, I got $100 I'd like to give. How would they get a hold of the charities then?
They can donate at our facility.
Oh,
they
just
can
right
either
at the
mail.
Place.
Yeah,
okay.
they can mail it, and we'll take care of taking it to Chesapeake Charities.
Okay. The towels, now, you need anything else besides towels and maybe toys or something? Or
we
what?
Spoke about the pet pantry program, so
food.
We get a lot of donated food as well. That's
okay.
always a need that we can use to
help us out with, you want, I assume, do you want dry food, canned food, both. Or what? Okay.
Yeah.
And again, just drop off or call or what?
They can drop off, call, come in, whatever works for them.
Okay.
And it doesn't have to be brand new bags. It can be open bags, so whatever they can donate, we'll accept.
I mean, it's all, you're making this too easy, come on. So again, that's help people out. If you're thinking, I would like to help the animal service, but you know what, I'm full-time work, I haven't got time, but you know what, I know I have some extra towels. I know I went to Acme and bought five cans that I'm never gonna use.
Right.
They could be dropped off,
right.
or the linen put in your linen bin.
Yes.
Like, what is easy? Oh, that's, come on, Ramon, this is making this too easy. And financial things, we got to be careful with,
right.
but there is a proper way to
right,
do it.
There is a proper.
Is there information for that on your website, if you want to
there
do
is
it?
Not information, but if they call in, we can
okay.
go review that.
And Ramon, I know we're going to keep doing this. Let's do this again. Phone, I'm watching this show, and I said, Fred, you're full of baloney, but I like this man, Ramon, all right, because he's a wrestler. He likes baseball.
Right.
What's the phone number again?
It's 410-827-7178.
Okay. And you need more, do you need more dog walkers? That's what
yes.
I see these delightful people, and then I look at the number of dogs. You need a lot, you need a few, or?
We can always use dog walkers, we can always use enrichment and socialization
okay.
volunteers.
I mean, if you like animals, and an hour a day,
yeah.
I mean, you're not gonna walk the dog for an hour, you walk them for 15 to 20 minutes, and that's fine, right?
Right?
And come on, I'm going to go home and Mrs. McNeil hopefully will watch this show. We're going to give you a couple of towels, all right? I promise they'll be clean, all right? Okay, make it easy. Ramon, let me ask you this. The future, where are we going? I mean, animal service, our population is going to grow in Queen Anne's County, whether we like it or not. Are animal services facilities and needs going to grow also, you think?
Yes. Right,
yes. Is our animal population growing? We don't knock on the doors and do a census,
right.
But are we growing animal-wise?
The intake numbers have been increasing since I've arrived in 2018.
Oh, they are increasing.
They are increasing, or they're maintaining steady. So part of my goals coming up is introducing TNR, for the
community.
What's TNR? And TNR is trap, neuter, return.
Oh, okay.
And it addresses the feral cat overpopulation problem.
Okay. Is that a problem in Queen Anne's County?
There is. And a lot of our cat intakes are feral cats.
Okay.
And each year we get in so many kittens.
Explain, I'm a dummy. Why do we have, what do people, cats, is it because the cats are populating too much, or is it
yes.
people just throwing cats out, or what?
Yeah, so it's a lot of cats who are free roaming and
just running around the woods,
and
okay.
they're just mating and having
okay.
litters.
Okay, is there a way we can help you as a community with that? I mean, in terms of if we get a cat we don't want it, rather than just throw it out the door and throw it in the woods, take it to you and you're going to take care of it. And is there any way the public can help that issue?
So we're trying to propose a way that will help at addressing the overpopulation in a humane way.
Okay, good.
But currently what folks can do is if they trap a feral cat, they can bring them to us. We'll fix the cats, we'll spay, neuter.
Okay, okay.
And we'll give them all the rabies vaccine and we'll return them to the owner.
Okay.
So
don't put them, we used to do some terrible things in the past I'm not even gonna
yes.
talk about. Don't do that.
Right.
Go to you for help.
Right. Okay. And we can always, help folks with, if they have an overpopulation issue, or if they just have basic nuisance cats that they just don't know how to handle.
Okay.
And the benefit of this TNR program is a lot of these nuisance complaints can be fixed by getting these animals altered, spayed
okay.
or neutered.
All right. Okay.
Because a lot of these feral cats the complaints are that they're roaming, or that they're spraying, or that they're yowling because it's mating season.
Right.
So by spay-neutering them, you're gonna eliminate these nuisances.
Ramon, if people are sitting at home and they say, I've seen dogs running around through the neighborhood, I've seen without tags or any, and I've seen cats. They just call you, and it used to be, the trucks used to go by, right, they were specially equipped, right, to get these animals. But you encourage that, people to help you out with that?
So we work with Queen Anne's County Animal Control. They're a separate agency.
Separate, totally
and
separate.
And they handle all the...
Okay, so they don't call you on that. They call Animal Control.
Right.
That's a whole different agency.
Yes.
Okay, that's something that's good. I'm glad you made that
right.
clear. If you do see, and I didn't know that right. you just told me, if you do see an animal running around that you're a little concerned about, right, don't call you, call Animal Control.
Yes.
Now, how about, and all the farmers give me heck every time I put a picture of a deer up and say, oh, I love it. Do you have anything to do with that, or is that Animal Control?
So wildlife is handled by the Maryland Department of Natural
it's
Resources.
Totally separate.
So
you don't
DNR.
Do that. Okay, so
yes.
they would call DNR. If they see a deer
yes.
who's eating their apples off the tree,
right.
or the farmers tell me, Fred, don't tell me how much you like Bambi.
Right.
They're killing my crops.
Right.
call DNR. That's
yes.
not your responsibility.
Right, correct.
Okay. Ramon, in a couple minutes we have left, let me go back to the question. Where do you see in the future? Are you going to grow? Do you
yes.
have more staff?
Yeah.
What are some immediate needs do you see the community needs to help with the animals?
So two things that we immediately need, and with the larger amount of animals that we take in a year, we have a very robust foster program.
Okay.
And this foster program, it's volunteer-based as well. And this foster program has allowed us to continue our life-saving mission.
Okay.
Because we mentioned how, as an open admission shelter, we accept all these strays.
People knock on the door, you're there to
right.
help them. You're there to help.
And for a lot of those animals, they're orphan kittens. There's some neonatal kittens that require around-the-clock care.
Just little babies.
Bottle babies.
Yeah,
and this program allows us to set them up for success in removing them from the environment in the shelter and putting them in a home.
Okay, so someone, just like foster care with children,
yes.
you take, is there a week, months, how long do you...
It depends on the needs of the animal and the age of the animal. So it really depends case by case. But the benefit of this foster program is we provide all the supplies needed.
Oh, so I'll take the animal. You're going to help me with the food and whatever else. Oh, no, that's easy.
And for any medical expenses, we take care of. So really, the foster only takes care of opening their home and taking
You're giving them love and care and a roof over their heads. You're going to give them food and everything and make it easy. Oh, that's a terrific program. Okay.
Right. And for those who can't dedicate that much time because of how much time these neonatal cats need, we do have a short-term foster program. And it's geared more towards taking out the dogs out of the kennel.
Okay.
And for a lot of folks, it can be taking them on a hike. And some folks will even take them on boat rides.
Oh, wow. So just for a couple hours or a day or two or what?
For a couple hours. It can be
great.
For a weekend.
Terrific price. So if you like animals, I already have some or I don't want the hassle, short term to help you out with that foster. Oh, that's another terrific thing. All right. That's the future. Is that the...
That's the immediate, what we're really looking to focus, because in 2021, we have sent close to 700 animals into our foster care program.
700?
Yeah, so it's very critical to our operations.
Yeah, that's 700 of 1,000. Am I doing the math right?
Right.
So that's 70%. There's nothing wrong with that. Yeah. Right. That sounds good to me.
Right.
Well, terrific. Well, Ramon, look, our time's about up. Now, I got to ask you some serious questions.
Sure.
Who's going to win the World Series? I know you're a baseball fan.
Well,
you got the Red Sox, you got the Dodgers, maybe the Red Sox.
Right.
What do you think's going to happen?
I'm going to root for the Dodgers just because they have a couple of the Nationals.
They have Scherzer.
Yeah.
They have
right.
Basically, I think we should all get rings.
Right.
Those are the cheer for the Nationals. So we gave them a team. Well, look, I really appreciate your time. It sounds like your agency is an amazing group. And people who love animals are going to love what you guys are doing down there. Now, before we go, again, I watched the show. I still have questions. What's the phone number again?
So it's 410-827-7178.
But it'd be easier for them, and you'd probably prefer, go to the county website, right? And on the county website, it will list animal services.
Yes.
And there'll be everything from volunteer forms and probably all the questions that I've messed up and you've answered properly that will be asked again.
Yes.
Okay? All right. Well, look, thanks a million for being with us.
Thank you.
And you know you have an open invitation anytime to come about animals. My dog Bear insists that you come, okay? And I hope you get folks. Look, we can all give some towels. We can all give some time. We can all, help out with the animals in the community. We're the human beings. We can show a little love and care to the animals we have. Ramon, good luck, and I hope you come back as often as you can. Next time, bring a pet if you can, okay?
Definitely will.
And in good shape. My name's Fred McNeil. Thank you for watching QAC TV 7. My time's up. Thank you for your time. We're going to see you next time, and my dog Bear appreciates this show.